When I share with my students that I believe obstacles are a gift, they often say to me, well, if you knew what I was going through, you would never say that obstacles are a gift. I even have had people say to me, if you think they're such a gift, you should be living my life. I'm Deborah Poneman, founder of Yes to Success, where for over 40 years, I've been sharing with people around the world how to live their ultimately successful lives. And my answer is always the same. I would be living your life if I were having your thoughts. And I don't mean to be disrespectful or flippant or unsympathetic, but whatever reality you're experiencing right now, financially, health-wise, in your career, in your relationships, it is your creation. There's just no way around it. If you plant an apple seed, you will not get a harvest of mangoes. Every single thing in your life is the harvest of a seed that you planted and nurtured at an earlier point in your soul's journey. And the way you nurture the seeds is really by the power of your attention. What we put our attention on is what will grow in our lives. So look at your thoughts. Are you thinking positive, expectant thoughts of success and well-being? Or are your thoughts more along the lines of, my life is such a mess and there is no way out? Now, I don't have to spend your precious time talking about the power of thoughts because that's Law of Attraction 101. We all got that when we watched The Secret. But if you no longer want to harvest difficulties, you have to start being more aware of what you're planting and nourishing. And I'm telling you, as sure as I am sitting here today, and I am sitting, that every little effort you make in this direction will be rewarded beyond your wildest dreams. If you take one step in the direction of planting something new, just one time that you're about to tell the story of your horrible childhood, just for some temporary relief or some temporary comfort, well, as the great teacher Karuna Mai says, you take one step. She says you take one step towards the creator and the creator will take 100 steps towards you. I think she actually says 1,000. And when you tell the story of your past, what you're doing is bringing the vibration of the past into the present, where it's going to draw what is vibrating like it right into your current life. So stop it. Take a breath and instead tell a wonderful moment of high vibration, or tell a wonderful vision of what you see your future can be. If you could only adopt the belief that we live in a friendly universe, that there's nothing about the energies of the universe, whether you call that force of creation God or spirit or creative intelligence or Fred, there is nothing vindictive. And that universal energy is not randomly creating your suffering. This force in the universe loves you more than the word love can even come close to describing. And just like you want to take the pain away when your own child suffers, the God of your understanding would love to take your pain away. But just as you know the gift it is to your own children to not run interference and protect them from every sling and arrow, and thus never letting them learn and grow how to get out of the way themselves, God, out of her great love for you, always allows you to have the experiences that you need to grow, to learn, to become stronger and more compassionate. In other words, it truly is all for your highest good. And you know, and I know that when you look back on your life, what seemed to be the greatest curse turned out to be the greatest blessing. And what seemed to be the greatest blessing, well, maybe it wasn't such a blessing at all. And the person who helped me internalize this was the great teacher, Byron Katie. She has a body of knowledge called The Work. And it's based on the realization she had when she woke up. And that is, when she believed that something should be different than it was, like my husband should be nicer to me, my children should respect me. And the reality is that he isn't nicer and they don't respect you, she suffered. And then when she didn't believe those thoughts, when she didn't believe that anything should be different than exactly as it was, she felt peace. She realized that what had been causing her suffering and her depression at the time was not the world around her, but her belief that the world around her should be different than it was. Katie says that through the lens of her own self-realization, that our attempt to find happiness is backwards. Instead of hopelessly trying to change the world and the people in it to match our thoughts about how it should be and they should be, we can just question our thoughts. And by meeting reality as it is, we can experience freedom and we can experience the end of suffering. I'll tell you one way her work has always helped me through tough times is by simply asking the question that she gives us, how do I know it's supposed to be exactly the way it is? And the answer is, because it is. Argue with reality and you will always lose, but only 100% of the time. So in my life, when something would happen that was painful, it wasn't so little, like my son missing the buzzer shot when he was supposed to be the closer in the final game of the tournament, or my making a business mistake that cost me tens of thousands of dollars. Of course, I breathe into the pain where I'm feeling it. And if there's a lesson there for me to learn, I ask what the lesson is. But after the mother load of pain that I am allowing myself to feel has diminished, I simply ask myself, how do I know it was supposed to happen the exact way it did? Because it did. If it was supposed to happen another way, it would have happened that way. So give not arguing with reality a try and see what happens. My hunch is that it will bring you great peace and deep understanding of the perfection of life. So thank you for spending this time with me. I wish you great prosperity, deep and lasting fulfillment as you live your ultimate life.